Here's the car wash. Training for weeks to try to get their turnaround time down. Okay. You should charge for this car wash. Wow, here come the bubbles. It's missing. All right. Ben.
Okay, here we have the team of Shanna Wang and Annie Openshaw and Martha Cheng. Can you tell us what's the name of your robot? What's the name?
Star Dragon.
The Star Dragon. Ooh, there he is. The Star Dragon. Tell us about the Star Dragon.
When you put its head, it'll come to you and smoke at you.
Smoke at you?
Yeah.
How endearing.
And it opens its wings often, and if you touch its ears, then its eyes will rotate.
Okay, can we see Star Dragon in action?
Does someone want to touch?
Who's going to be the brave soul who will touch the Star Dragon?
Touch
a
snout.
Right now. Okay. Whoa! I think you set him off there. Okay. What is he? That looks dangerous. I think you've seen Jurassic Park. Oh no! Oh, that's too cool. That is just too cool. Wow. That is great.
Smoke.
That is great. Now his eyes go goo goo googly.
Yeah.
What makes his eyes go goo goo googly? Oh, you touch his ears and he's not all too happy about that. Yeah. That is awesome. That is awesome. Wow.
It's a shame, isn't it?
That's great. Well, thank you very much for showing us Star Dragon. Okay. Here we are visiting the Wizard of Oz again, and I have just learned that all of these... Gabrielle, can you tell us more about these figures here?
These figures, they're all made by this really light clay-like stuff that's called Model Magic.
Uh-huh.
And so
that's Dorothy and Toto there?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then it's painted with watercolors. And it dries really fast.
Uh-huh. Who else do we have? We have a bird. And we have there's a witch over here, right?
But
she's hidden away.
She doesn't come out until later.
Okay, we see the hat of the witch, and we saw the munchkins before.
Here are the munchkins.
Can we see the munchkins?
Hiding under the mask. We can start it again.
Yeah, let's start it tonight. Oh no, there's a tornado.
Yeah, and there's the wicked witch.
Sometimes he turns around too, but
uh-huh.
Not today.
Watch for the witch over here.
Uh-huh. Those creatures are incredible. Really, really, that's fantastic. So who made the creatures? Who made the people?
I did.
You did? That's incredibly artistic. It's wonderful. Thank you.
Natalie made Toto.
Uh-huh.
No, go ahead.
Delaney?
When he gets to the other side.
What's the name of your project?
He's a chicken.
He's a chicken, okay.
When you get to the other side, what you're going to do is you want to catch his egg. So you just put your hand a little above this black thing and catch him.
Okay, let's see the chicken in motion here.
Okay. We're hoping the chicken goes in motion this time. He's not the liking it.
I see he's a good chicken and looks both ways.
It's not like he is right there.
But can you tell me, why does he cross the road?
He crosses the road because he has a little reflective sensor right here. And when he hits the black, he knows he's at the road. And so,
hey!
Oh wow, he backs up.
He laid a lot of eggs this time.
Wow. That's so cute.
Excellent. Thank you, Delaney. So here we have the Western Duel that was created by Lisa Latman and Virginia Butler. Can you tell us a little bit about your project before you start it off?
Okay, well, these guys are sheriff and an outlaw, and they're leaving the saloon to have a little old-fashioned gunfight. And they move forward and they face back to back. And the theme to the Lone Ranger plays. To start off the duel, they take a few paces away from each other, and then they face off and start their guns, and that part is random, so we don't ever know which one's going to kill the other one. And
the tension is palpable.
One of them dies and plays the taps.
Okay, can we see him in action?
Yes, hopefully.
There he goes. Okay. Okay, they're about to duel.
Draw, partner.
Uh-oh! Yay!
That's great.
Gonna see.
There he is.
It's all over for this outlaw. He used to be a good man before he turned to the dark side. All you viewers out there, remember, this could happen to you. Thank you very much. Patricia Diaz and Rachel Schwartz, who are going to present The Touchlater. Can you tell us what The Touchlater is?
Okay, well, The Touchlater developed out of an idea of Patricia's and Leonardo's. Patricia's father.
Wait a second, we gotta say hi to Leonardo. Hi, Leonardo. Yes?
Patricia's father-in-law has recently become blind and deaf, so he can ask a question to you, but there's no way for you to get an answer back to him. So this device is built in an attempt to give an answer, so it can give a thumbs up for yes, a thumbs down for no, a thumbs to the side for maybe, and then it can tap out numbers.
Mm-hmm.
So if you ask a yes or no question, we might
so can we get a close-up of the
device
here? Okay.
So do you have a yes or no question? Or you can ask a question.
Was it difficult to make this project?
Yes.
That's a yes. Okay.
And then it can give
if you had a chance to take this, of course, again, would you?
Probably would have. Yeah.
I want to go over and see something else.
Okay. Is that a no or is that a maybe or what is
that?
That was a no, okay.
But you can also ask how many inches of snow there is.
Okay, how many inches of snow is there? One, two, three, four. There's a lot of inches. Five. Six. There's 6 inches of snow. That's great. Now, I was here last Sunday, and you actually had your grandfather here checking this device out. What did he think of it?
Oh, he
loves the tapping.
Uh-huh.
I think it's much better tapping than rotate.
Uh-huh.
We like it. It's very light. It's
yes, nice. It is very light.
So you can put it in your belt.
Uh-huh.
Through this little hole.
That's great. Now, it's worth emphasizing to the viewers here that although this looks small and simple, it is only small and simple because they spent weeks of design making it small and simple. So, sometimes the smallest things are actually the hardest to design. Thank you very much, Rachel. Thank you, Patricia.
Oh, the tower is melting.
Now we start the game with dragon.
Okay, so what do you have to do to defeat the dragon?
To defeat the dragon, you have two weapons. One is a laser gun / flashlight.
Looks like a lightsaber.
Aha! So when it was before, it was blinking just red. Now it's blinking green.
Yeah, you gotta hit him in the heart here.
Okay. Can you show us how that works? Oh,
he stopped.
He's going to be now stopped. The tower
and
be
right. And the tower is saved. Oh my gosh! That's amazing. Wow!
If only life were like that.
Thank you.
You can tell by his eyes that he's angry.
Okay, so here we have...
Anybody? Demonstrator? Anybody?
Here we have Lynn and Lynn Wang and Bridget Demain and Camille Castillo, who's not here. Can you tell us what the name of your project is?
Tower of Love.
Tower of Love. Let's take a look at the tower here. I see we have a meter with three areas, one called Splitsville, one called Friends Forever. One is True Love. And here we have, here apparently we have
the two sensors.
Do we have any people who want to test if they're in love?
Come on.
Come on. Here we go. Let's test if you're in love. Here you go. Yeah, just press. And
come on, we expect
what's going to happen?
Good enough?
Yes.
Uh-oh, it's going all the way to true love!
Wow. It's not even Valentine's
Day. Okay, what happens here?
Uh-oh. Okay. Sometimes it gets a little shabby. There are light sensors on the box.
That's it.
That was pretty bad. Sorry.
So I see the little bug there is doing a dance to celebrate your love. Wow.
Swing, cha-cha, swing.
So it's worth taking a look at this mechanism on the CD player. That's just a little lever that when it gets pressed turns the pause button on and off. Excellent. So has anyone done Splitsville so far?
Splitsville. No, not
really.
No. Do you want to get a prize?
No.
Good.
Can I take one from my true love?
Oh, sure.
There you go.
It's coming out. Okay. Oh, no, you heard the bomb already.
That's awesome.
Whoops! Uh-oh!
This tower's low.
That is great.
Yeah, good job, guys.
That is really great. Thank you, Lynn.
Thank you,
Bridget. What happens in the park?
You pick up the ball, so you hit it up, and then you sit down.
Wow!
Catch that one. What about another one? Another flower.
See what happens here.
Oh, cool.
Try another flower.
Oh, who's we have little birdies?
Are you doing that? Little birdies.
Uh-huh. What happens with the last flower? Uh-oh. I think that flower needs to go back in. Okay.
What happens with the last flower? How do you like the little birdie?
Nice though.
Can we see the last flower, Alex?
Look over here.
Oh, wow, the swing.
You like
okay, here we... Ah, oh, and they're off.
Bunny's pulling ahead. Bunny's pulling ahead. In fact, as a matter of fact, the bunny's so confident.
Yeah. Oh, no.
So confident.
And this slow and steady.
Over here on the bunny.
Up. But it's too late.
It's just too late.
Yeah. Jessica.
Okay, here we're visiting our friend the mouse. And the mouse this time is connected to the computer, so we can actually see that it's drawing. So as the mouse moves, he's leaving behind a rubber band line. That is great.
Turn into Lego Mindstorms, and Torben is here to give you some brief welcoming remarks. Torben?